Good evening, family. Good evening, good evening, good evening. God bless you all for joining in. You're welcome. You're welcome. God bless everyone who is connected. God bless you all. You're welcome to our Friday Miracle Service. And I am excited. I don't know about you, but we say glory be to God. Amen. Amen. And we give glory to God for what he has done, what he's doing in our life, his faithfulness, his mercy, his loving kindness. The Lord has been too much, you know, from the start of the year till now. It is just by the grace of the Lord. I don't know who is doing it on their own, but we know we serve a living God who is above, who is watching us, who is with us, who is fighting for us, amen, who is fighting our battles, amen, who is watching over us and delivering us from evil day in and day out, at night, at day, at noon. He is with there. He's fighting our battles, amen. So today, you know, we want to say that, Lord, you are good and you are merciful. We want to say thanks be to God for he giving us the chance for us to meet as a family and to be in his presence. Amen. That I'm it's like, you're not excited to be in the presence of the Lord. Everyone is quiet. You're not excited. I want us to shout a big amen to the Lord tonight. Amen. For he is faithful. Amen. 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 And hallelujah. Amen. Everyone, God bless you.
God bless you.
God bless you. God bless you. Today, I want to acknowledge my father, Apostle Gene Elias. Papa, I want to say God bless you for giving us the opportunity to be here in the first place. Thank you for all your prayers, the love. We appreciate you. We honor you. Thank you so much for being a generational blessing.
And
we love you. Thank you, Papa. We also want to acknowledge our mother, Mama Denise. Mama Denise, thank you for being a great blessing unto us, all your children worldwide. All of us are benefiting. Thank you so much for being a blessing. God bless you. We also want to acknowledge our grandfather in the faith, Prophet Livy Elias. We want to say, Grandpa, we acknowledge you. We honor you tonight. You're a blessing to us all.
Amen.
We also honor the leadership, everyone here, all the prophets, prophetess, you know, pastors, everyone here. God bless you for tuning in and joining in. You know, you're a great blessing to us all, and everyone on social media, everyone connected on YouTube, Facebook, TikTok, everywhere, Twitter, everywhere. Stay connected to be blessed. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Right. You know, we have to prove to the devil that we're alive.
Now,
sometimes the only difference between those that are alive and those who are dead is that they just can't speak. It's a permanent thing currently. And when you go into the cemetery, you will not hear when there's a pin that goes down, you can even hear that sound. We are in the presence of the Lord. Amen. It's a praise be to the Lord, oh my soul. Bless the Lord, oh my soul, and all that is within me, bless his holy name. Amen. And I don't know which other God that we serve. It is just our one true God, our only God, our holy King of Kings and Lord of Lords. He is the one that we will worship till eternity. Amen. From generation to generation, he is still the same. He never changes. He is still the same God. He is still the same God. Today, I want to encourage all of us that we are going to bless the name of the Lord. Amen. I want to say that, you know, let's really pray. Let's really bless the name of the Lord. I want everyone to be connected, to be alive. I want everyone to say, Lord, you are good. Lord, you are merciful. Lord, you have shown us great mercy.
Amen.
See, think about the mercies of the Lord. If it had not been for his mercy, where would you be? Ask yourself. It is by the great mercies of the Lord that we are counted amongst the living this evening. Not by might and not by power, but by the Spirit, saith the Lord. By the Spirit, saith the Lord. It is the Spirit that quickeneth. The flesh profited nothing. So it is our spirits that are going to bless the Lord this evening. Amen. So wherever you are, we say, like, Lord, you are good. Lord, you are merciful. Lord, you have shown us great mercy. Wherever you are, let's give thanks to God in the name of Jesus. Lord, you are worthy. Lord, you are worthy. Lord, you are worthy. Lord, God Almighty.
Lord of Lords, be exalted
Wonderful. You know, some people might not understand when we come into the presence and we are yelling and we are saying glory be to God. We are saying, Lord, you are holy. Some people don't get it. And I understand because when it was the Pentecost day, when the disciples were gathered in that room and they were praying in the Holy Ghost, what happened was people thought they were drunk with wine. Yes. You know, there are people that were laughing and mocking that you are drunk with wine. And so some people will not understand. But if you can connect with the Holy Spirit here, if you can connect with the grace and the house.
Come on.
Oh, Jesus, the Lord is about to do great things in our life today. Yeah. And I want to read a scripture that will let us know that the Holy Spirit is with us.
Amen.
Amen. John chapter 14, verse 16. It says that, and I will ask of the Father, and he will give you another advocate to help you and be with you forever. And so when two or more people are gathered, there he is. So the Lord is with us. The Holy Spirit is with us. Amen. We need the Spirit of the Lord. It is that, you know, we need the Lord to be here with us, that every word that is coming out of the preacher's mouth will be a blessing unto us, amen. Yes. That it will not fall on a land that is so hard, but it will fall on a land that is fertile, amen. Yes. But we need the Holy Spirit. We need the Holy Spirit to really help us because he's the advocate. Yes. In other scriptures, it says it's the comforter. He's coming to comfort, amen. So we need the Holy Spirit tonight. Amen.
Amen.
To lead us and to help us.
Yes.
Tonight we are praying for the Holy Spirit to take charge in the name of Jesus. Yes. We cannot do it on our own. That even when the word comes, we need the Spirit of the Lord to even help us understand the word that is coming. Yes, to even help us process the word that is coming. Yes. To help us keep the word in our hearts. Amen. For the word to abide in us. So let us pray in the name of Jesus. Let us pray. Yes. Father, we pray that, oh God, in the name of Jesus, let your Spirit take control. Let your power take control. Let your Spirit take control. Instead of God, the one who are God and they are. Today, you are not present like never before. Your eyes on God, where you are going. There are many things coming ahead of us. Thank you for giving us hope.
Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah.
Oh, yes, oh God. Yes. Father, we thank you for being in our midst, oh God. We thank you that the word that is coming is settling in our hearts, oh God. That from generation, this word will not go void, but it will bear fruits, and the fruits will be plenty, oh God. Will be fruitful. In Jesus' name, thank you, O Lord, for great things that you have established in our lives, in our family here.
Jesus.
In Jesus' name, I pray thanksgiving. Amen. Amen. God bless everyone.
Amen. Amen. God
bless you. Yes.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
My God.
Amen.
Oh, if you're happy to be in the house of the Lord, I want you to shout fire. The louder your shout, the louder your testimony.
Amen. Fire.
Amen.
If you can shout hallelujah, I see great doors opening for you.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
If you can shout hallelujah one more time, I see great testimony coming for you.
Hallelujah.
Thank you. The louder your hallelujah, the louder your testimony.
Hallelujah. Amen.
Oh my God. I wish you understand what you are doing. In the realms of the prophetic, nothing makes sense because the spiritual things cannot make sense to the carnal person. But if you are spiritual, I want you to shout hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
One more time, somebody shout fire.
Hallelujah.
Somebody shout fire. Tonight you are going to Africa and we hallelujah. Somebody shout fire.
Fire.
Hallelujah. If you're excited to be in the house of the Lord, I want you to type fire. Wherever you are, I want you to glorify the name of the Lord Jesus Christ.
Father, we thank you.
In the name of Jesus, Father, we give you the name of Jesus.
We honor you, Lord Jesus Christ, our Lord and Savior.
Yes,
Father, you are God forever and ever. You are.
Yes,
you are God from the ancients of days. You are God in the modern of days.
Yes.
Father, you existed before the beginning began because you are the beginning. Father, everything exists within you because everything can only exist within you. Father, you are the Father of the fathers. You are the God of all gods. And you are the King of all kings. And you are the Lord of all lords. Your name is Jehovah Gemolah. Your name is Jehovah Jikopokopo. The Lord that makes no runway. Your name is Jehovah Sikenu. Your name is Jehovah El. Your name is Jehovah Rufiki. Your name is Jehovah Rapha. Your name is Adonai. Your name is Elion. Your name is Elohim. Your name is Jesus Christ. You are God forever and ever. We are
Amen.
Hallelujah. But we thank you for you always be. Father, you are, oh God, and we thank you for always being, oh Lord. Father, we present ourselves before you. We say, oh God Almighty, the Rock of Ages, Father, take preeminence tonight in the name of Jesus Christ. Father, we never come to encounter man, Father. We came to encounter you, O Lord, through a man.
Thank you, Lord.
Jesus. Yes. In the name of Jesus Christ. Father, I'm just a man. Father, take me out of the way. Father, let your presence be. And Father, minister to us. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Father,
hallelujah.
Anything that will be fleshy, take away. Anything that we cannot take away. Father, let everything that will be done tonight be spiritual, yes, in the name of Jesus Christ. Yes. Holy Spirit, you know how we do it every time.
Thank
Holy
you,
Spirit, in your seat. We have come to draw, yes, from you again. We have come to, yes, drink, Lord, from the well of salvation. We have come to drink from the well of revelation and mystery.
Yes,
Holy,
Lord,
Spirit, Holy Spirit, take your seat. We have come to draw from you again. In the mighty name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen.
Jesus. Amen.
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 Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen.
Wow. Somebody say wow.
Wow.
I think you guys are not happy today. Maybe you are not happy to see me.
Yes, I'm happy to see you, Prophet.
I am very happy.
Thank you, Jesus.
God bless you, Mama. God bless you.
Yes, hallelujah. I'm very happy.
If you're happy to see me, I want you to copy the link and I want you to share.
Amen.
Okay.
Copy the link and share. Amen. Copy the link and share.
Amen.
We are 26. You can do better.
Amen.
Amen.
We can do better, yes, than this. Please, amen, copy the link and I want you to share. Copy the, yes, link and share.
Amen.
Copy the link and share. If you are, yes, done sharing, yes, just type, I am done. I am done. I am done. Yesterday, only two people shared. I'm so hurt. I'm looking at it. Please share today. Do the Lord. Bless the Lord with your sharing. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Share, share, share.
Yes.
God bless you, Mama. Mama Isa and Papa Ketis. God bless you.
Yes.
Share the link. Share the link. Share the link. Share the link.
Amen.
I want you to, Mama, too much. Mama is doing it.
You know it.
Mama is doing it. Please.
You know it.
Kindly do it. My God.
You know it.
Mama, I've done it. Please do it.
Amen.
My God. Mm-hmm. Kindly. Mama Martha, God bless you. You are too much. Please share the link. Share the link. Share the link. Share the link. If you're on Zoom, if you're on YouTube, I want you to share and share. Hit the like button.
Amen.
Hit the like button. Share it. Share, yep, it. Let, amen, people join in. Let people join in. My God, my God, my God, my God. Malinoshka vende karia dabasus e paradios. Kindly share the link. Share, yes, the link. Let people come and join. People need to be blessed. Listen to me, ladies and gentlemen. You don't know who you might be touching.
Maybe,
that's right, this is the form of evangelism you can do. Maybe this is the only evangelism you can do. You cannot go to the street and share the word of God. Maybe you are shy, but with this, you cannot be shy. You are not, amen, going to minister to anybody. You are just copying the link and sharing. Hallelujah.
That's
so
it.
Do it. Copy,
that's
the,
it,
link and share. Today, let us hit the threshold of 100. We can do it. We are better than this. Hallelujah.
That's right.
So
that's
copy,
right,
the link. If everyone, we are 26, if everyone can share, okay, if we are 26, let's do this mass. If you can share and we are getting additional one person, you've hit 50 plus just,
amen,
on Zoom.
Amen.
That's right.
Before Instagram, before Twitter, my God, somebody say, my God.
My God, my God.
My God, my God, yes.
So I'm waiting for you. I'm waiting for you. Copy the link and share. If you don't share, you are not starting. Hallelujah. My God. First of all, I want to appreciate my spiritual father. Papa, mm-hmm, I'm so humble.
Amen.
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 Amen. Jesus Christ. I'm so
appreciative.
Amen.
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 I appreciate my spiritual father.
Amen. God bless you, Papa.
Yes.
Amen.
Yes.
God bless you, Grandfather.
God bless you, Papa. God bless you. With solid grace, with the same energy, I want us to appreciate my spiritual mama.
Amen.
God bless you. God bless you. God bless you, Mama. I want us, all of us, to appreciate our spiritual grandfather in the faith. Papa,
yes. Amen.
Papa,
amen.
Amen. God bless you.
Yes.
Amen.
Yes. Yes.
Grandpa. God bless,
yes,
you. And church, I want us to appreciate all the leaders and elders in Alta International. It's by their,
woo,
words that we are,
amen,
this call. Hallelujah. Amen. So I want everyone to appreciate them. I want everyone to appreciate them, please, with their with a hand to the cross.
Amen. Yes.
God bless you all. And last but not the least, I want you to appreciate yourself for being here.
Amen.
Today is Friday.
Amen.
Amen.
You could have been out there, but by grace, you are here. So appreciate yourself.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. I could have also been out there, so please appreciate me.
Amen. Amen, sir.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Wow.
Oh, Jesus.
Tonight, I brought a mystery from the heavens to you. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Amen.
The Bible makes us understand that unto you have been given the mysteries of the kingdom. I want you to understand this mystery, and I want you to understand the best way you can. You see, the total embodiment of the Lord Jesus Christ is full of mysteries. The kingdom of God is full of mysteries from the beginning to end.
Amen.
Every day we uncover mysteries. And I always say that mysteries are given to children of the kingdom for the advantage of the king of the children of the kingdom.
Amen.
Mysteries are given to the children of the kingdom for their advantage. Amen. Whenever a mystery is given to you, it means that God wants you to get an advantage over the commoner.
Amen.
Mysteries are hidden secrets that is confined only to the initiated for the advantage of them. Whenever a man or a woman shares his or her secret with you, you are at the advantage because at any time you can use it against the person or even, excuse me to say, blackmail the person.
Yep. Mm-hmm. Man, preach it.
Secrets are plus in life. Secrets in the realms of the spirit is a plus for you to be at an advantage.
Amen.
Whenever you know a mystery in the realms of the spirit, you grow in the realms of the spirit.
Amen.
The last time I was sharing that when the angel of the Lord, by grace, in the name of the Lord Jesus, by grace, when the angel of the Lord was speaking to me, he was telling me, he said, even in the realms of light, angels move higher based on the knowledge and revelation they have.
Yes.
The Bible says, blessed be these angels who excel in strength, in knowledge, in wisdom. Angels graduate higher based on the quantum of mysteries they uncover and reveal. That's what I want to understand, that even angels seek to know the affairs of men. They seek to know what men know because it is a mystery. The Son of God, the Lord Jesus Christ, God in man, was hidden from angels and was revealed unto men. This is one of the greatest mysteries in the kingdom. So even angels seek to know the affairs of men. Angels seek to uncover the mysteries of men. The Bible says, who is man that you are mindful of, or the son of man that you visit? For you have made him a little lower than Elohim. You have made him a little lower than you, God.
Yes.
Even seek to know the mysteries of men. I want you to understand this mystery. Tonight, by the message of the Lord Jesus Christ, I came to unveil the mystery of meditation to you.
Preacher!
The kingdom of God is based on a mystery called meditation. One on the battlefield of every individual is the mind, which is the soul. For you to excel, for you to ride over the processes and the wills and devices of the enemy, you need to know how to meditate in order to override the plans and powers of darkness.
Amen. Amen.
The first battle in life starts from the mind. Meditation takes place in the mind. Meditation gives you the strength to override every attack of the enemy. I'm telling you this, Mr.
Amen. Yes.
But first of all, we need to understand what is meditation. Whenever you see meditation in the Bible, the next thing you identify is success. prosperity and blessing. Mm-hmm. Whenever mm-hmm. you see meditation, the next thing you identify is progress, success, mm-hmm. blessing. Joshua. Now, let us read this famous scripture. The Bible makes us understand in Joshua 1 verse 8 mm-hmm. that this book of the law shall not depart from your mouth, but you should meditate upon it day and night and yes. observe to do what is written in it. Then you will make your way prosperous.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
I read again. The Bible is saying, for this book of the law should mm-hmm. not depart from your lips, but yes. you should meditate upon it day and night and observe to do what is written in it. Mm-hmm. Then you will make your way prosperous. Meaning prosperity is dependent on your ability to meditate.
Yes. Yes. Yes.
Amen.
You're not getting the revelation.
Yes. Amen.
Prosperity is dependent on your ability to meditate.
Yes.
Now we need to understand what meditation is. Is meditation just a grammar? Is meditation just a word? Or meditation is a spiritual system that we need to uncover.
System.
Now, the word meditation comes from the Hebrew word hagar and comes from the Greek word legizomai. Hagar means to ponder, to imagine, to think, to do a critical thinking about something.
Mm-hmm.
Are you following with me? I want you to follow with me.
Yes.
Meditation
means to ponder.
Yes.
To imagine.
Ponder.
To think. To have a critical thinking, to analyze something.
Yes, sir.
Why is the Bible making us understand that this book of the law should not depart from your lips, but you should ponder over it. You should critically think about it. You should analyze it and observe to do. Why? Because the mind is a place or it's a battlefield that if you're able to analyze and scrutinize things, you'll be able to be successful in life. Because the first process to be successful is always in the mind. Yes. That's why in the world, there's something called affirmation. The reason why we do affirmation is for you to unconsciously sink the repetition of words in your soul so it becomes part of you.
Yes.
Amen.
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 I think I need to break it down.
Amen.
I think I need to break it down. Let me break it down further.
Yes,
let
come on.
Everyone open their Bible to Joshua 1:8. Let it push it down there.
Mm-hmm.
Joshua 1:8. I want everyone to open their Bible. If you cannot find Joshua, it is in the book of Revelation. After Revelation, you see Joshua. If you don't see Joshua, I think we need all of you. You need all of you. Hallelujah. So Joshua 1:8. Then I read, this book of the law shall not depart from your lips or your mouth, but you should hagar over it day and night. And you may observe to do everything written in it. For then you will make your way prosperous and you have good success. Meaning good success and prosperity is dependent on your ability to think.
Amen.
On your ability to hagar, on your ability to ponder over things. Now, we see the same thing happening in Genesis 1. Why? In Genesis 1, verse 2, the Bible is saying, and the Spirit of the Lord was hovering over the face of the waters, or over the face of the deep. Then God said, let there be light. The word good comes from the word rakaf. Rakaf means to be in constant oscillation, constant movement, which is to constantly think. So the first thing that Elohim did on it was first to ponder over the architecture of the land, before God said, let there be light. There be light.
Mm-hmm. Amen.
Amen.
So for for Adonai to have success on the earth through creation, there was something called meditation that took place before, let there be light. Mm, mm.
Mm. Yes, sir.
That's it. Deep.
Why do you think to establish any business, the first process is to think about the business?
That's right.
If you fail to think critically about the business you're about to execute, automatically you fail in advance.
True.
That's right.
So there is a principle in the realms of the spirit. For you to override the rules and strategies of the enemy, there is something called meditation that you need to be in order to override the rules and strategies of the devil.
Amen.
Amen.
Because the guy that you are fighting against is a critical thinker.
Yes, the devil
Come to you with literal weapon. He will always come to you with defensive mechanism just to break you down. And the first place of attack is not your body, but your mind.
That's right.
Because if attacks your mind and breaks you down in your mind, automatically you are broken forever.
Deep.
The first place of attack, ladies and gentlemen, even when it comes to sickness, the first place of attack is your mind.
Yes.
Amen.
When you give up in your mind, automatically your body has shut down to every sickness that comes in.
Mm-hmm.
When you're broken spiritually, the first place that brokenness takes place is the mind.
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. Amen.
So true. Ladies and gentlemen, it is.
To know how to meditate on the law of Adonai in order to have good success.
Amen.
Let's go to Psalm 1, and I'll give you this revelation in Psalm 1. Psalm 1. Holy Ghost, you are God. Now let us read Psalm 1. The Bible says, blessed is the man. I told you, whenever you see meditation, you will always find blessing, prosperity, progress there.
Mm-hmm.
The Bible is saying someone, now blessed is the man. The word blessed comes from the word ashar, which means to increase.
Mm.
Listen to me. Ladies and gentlemen, the reason why I usually love the original writing of the Bible, it makes us know what the writer really meant or what the writer is trying to make the reader understand. Mm-hmm. Because whenever I'm speaking to you in my native language, I'm able to express myself better.
Yes.
Amen.
And it makes the listener know what I'm really talking about.
Yes.
So if you read the Hebrew Bible of someone, the Bible says, Asa. And it doesn't just say Asa, it says Asa with exclamation.
Mm-hmm.
Get this revelation. When you're reading the Hebrew Bible of someone, it starts Asa with exclamation.
Mm-hmm.
The writer is trying to let you know something that which is happening in this particular verse, that blessed.
Amen.
The writer is stressing on the word blessed, which is Asa.
Mm-hmm.
The etymology of the word Asa comes from the word increase, growth, progress, prosperity.
Go there.
Amen. Amen. Amen.
So the Bible or the writer is telling the reader that here, blessed, increase, progress, happiness is the man who does what? Let's continue now. I'm trying to teach you this particular verse. So the Bible is saying, Asa, which is blessed with exclamation, is the man who walks not in the counsel of the ungodly.
Mm-hmm.
The word walk in this particular verse of the Bible comes from the Hebrew word halak, which means to live in a place. So the Bible is saying, blessed is the man who does not live in the counsel. The word counsel comes from the Hebrew word etsa, which is advice. Blessed is the man who does not live in the advice of the ungodly.
Amen.
Amen. Amen.
I want you to flow with me. Just listen.
Amen.
Don't worry. At the end of the day, you understand what someone was talking about.
Amen. Amen.
I'm trying to break it down to the bare minimum.
Breaking it down.
Yes, you are. Yes, you are.
Increase, progress, growth is the man who does not live in the advice of the ungodly. The word ungodly comes from the Hebrew word rasha, which means wrong morals, bad morals. Mm. Blessed is the man who does not live in the advice of someone who has bad morals.
Yeah.
Amen. Yeah.
Man,
oh, yeah.
Not stand.
Oh, yes.
Not stand. The word stand comes from the Hebrew word amad, which means to remain.
Mm, okay.
So first, the person is walking. Mm-hmm. Now, the person stand, which is amad, to remain. Blessed is the man who does not to remain in the path of sinners. Now, the word path comes from the Hebrew word derik. Derik means direction. First, it was an advice, not direction. They are giving you direction now.
Ah, okay.
When a man of God prophesies to you, the next thing is to give you direction.
Amen.
The word is the advice. The direction is what you do. So first, you are the person walks in the counsel or the advice of the ungodly. The next thing is that he stands or remains in the direction of the wicked.
Yes.
Amen.
Yes.
I hope you understand.
Amen. Yes, we do. We
got
yes,
I understand. Is the man who does not walk or lives in the advice of the ungodly, nor stand into brackets, remains amad in the rick, the direction of sinners, not sits. So first he was walking. The next he stands. The next thing that he sits, not sits in the seat.
Okay.
Yes. My God. Yes.
Amen.
First, he was what? He was walking. The next, he stands. And the next thing that's what? He sits. But here is the mystery. Yeah. He said, not sit in the seat of the scornful. The seat is for scornful. Therefore, anyone that sits in that seat is a scornful. So automatically, when you sit, you are already part of the people.
My Lord.
Amen.
My God.
Yes. Yes. Get a revelation. Yes. The Bible is saying, "Not sit in the seat of the scornful." Anyone that sits in that seat is already a scornful.
Amen.
So first, the person is walking. The next is remains. Automatically, when you remain or you stand in the direction of the ungodly, you become part of them. Why? Because the next thing is that you are sitting in your own seat, which is the seat of the scum.
My God.
Amen.
The next thing, let's read the next thing, the next verse.
Okay. Yes.
The next verse is what? But he delights in the law of the Lord. And in the law he meditates day and night. Just like Joshua 1:8. This book of the law shall not depart from your lips, but you should meditate upon it day and night and observe to do what is written in it. Then you have good success. We are seeing success in meditation day and night here. In Psalm 1, we are seeing the same thing written there. But his delight is in the law of the Lord. And in the law, he meditates day and night. Delight. Now, the word delight comes from the Hebrew word hafet, which means to desire, to long. Excuse me to say, to lust after, sorry, but to long, like that form of desire.
Yes.
But his desire is in the Torah of Adonai.
Yes.
Torah is group of laws, directions, revelations, rules of God. But his delight is in the Torah of the Lord. And in the Torah, he meditates day and night.
Mega.
The next thing we are seeing, the next thing that we are seeing is this. After he meditates day and night, now he shall be like a tree planted by the river.
Jesus.
If you read other scriptures, The Bible says, he shall be like a tree firmly planted, meaning your ability to be firm in life is dependent on how you're able to meditate.
Amen.
Yes.
Why do you think you're able to stand firm based on meditation? Because it is in the realm of meditation that is when your faith is really established. Because in the realms of meditation, you analyze, you have God, you are able to marginalize, you're able to think and have deep information and deep analytical points for you to stand firm in life. Now, after you have solid points, you are not shaken by anything that comes in your way.
Amen.
Yeah. For example, it's like a child. A child thinks that his father or her father can beat anyone in the world. Mm-hmm. Why? Because he or she has grown up to the point or with the idea that his father is strong.
That's
so
right.
He has that faith in the father. Why? Because of what he knows he has meditated on.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
So he has faith now. He is firm in his father that no one can beat his father.
That's right. That's right.
Even if his father is like me, as slim as I am, he still thinks that his father can beat anyone in the world. Hallelujah.
That's right.
Amen.
Why? Because of meditation, the child has grown out to be. So the Bible is making that statement that he shall be as firm as a tree planted by the riverside. Why? Because of what? Meditation day and night.
Yes.
Amen.
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 I wish you understand what I'm trying to teach you.
Amen. Amen, sir.
Now, the next thing you see is this. That bring forth its fruit in its season.
Mm-hmm.
Get this revelation here.
Okay.
It shall be like a tree planted by the rivers of water. Mm-hmm. That brings forth fruits in its season. Yes. So whenever it's its season, the tree brings forth fruit. Whenever you are in your season, you always bring fruit.
Amen.
You produce results. Now, when you are off season, what happens? Get revelation here. That brings forth its fruit, its results in its season, whose leaf also shall not wither, and whatever he does, he prosper. The Bible says, its fruit, its leaf shall not wither. Meaning, whenever you are not even in season, whenever you are out of season, your leaves will not wither, meaning you're able to maintain your grip even when you're not in season.
Amen.
Amen.
Good teaching.
The Bible is saying,
real good. Real good.
Produce its fruit whenever it's in its season. And whenever it's out of season, its leaves shall not wither. Meaning, it's able to maintain its grip even when it's not in season.
Mm-hmm.
Why? Because it's planted by a riverside. In the state of meditation, whenever you've gotten to the point where the word has become part of you, the Bible says that, and the word became flesh and dwelt among men, and we beheld his glory as the firstborn son, meaning the word has become part of you now, it's part of your flesh. Whenever you are not even in season, you will not wither. Why? Because of meditation, you're able to maintain your grip.
Amen. Go with it.
Amen. Amen.
Meditation. So meditation, whenever you are able to meditate, whenever you're able to imagine, ponder, think, analyze the word of God, analyze even the business you're about to do. One thing I've realized after listening to great men, businessmen, gurus, professors, I realized that these people always do something called meditation before they step out. They always try to analyze things before they execute them. Whenever a businessman is about to have a business deal, he or she always try to meditate about the business before they execute it.
Amen. Yes.
Even a salesperson is about to give you a sales pitch, the first thing that he does is to analyze the pitch. I don't like the person he's about to speak to. And this is called realms of meditation.
That's right.
So even in the world, they understand what is called meditation. Meditation is a realm of analysis, is a realm of critical thinking, a realm of science where I analyze what I'm thinking about for me to sink deep. One thing I want you to understand is this, ladies and gentlemen, meditation is the language of the spirit.
Yes.
Amen.
Yes, amen.
So what language do you think God spoke when he said, let there be light? Ladies and gentlemen, it was in English.
English.
Neither was it Hebrew. It was called, it is called meditation.
Jesus.
It is called meditation. It is called meditation. Somebody say meditation.
Meditation.
Meditation. I want us to go to Psalm 19, verse 14. Let me teach you one mystery there. Realms of meditation.
Yes.
Psalm 19, verse 14. Holy Spirit, we love you. Thank you, Holy Spirit. The Bible says, let the words of my mouth and the meditations of my heart be what be acceptable in your sight.
Yes.
Amen.
Amen.
The words of my mouth and the meditations of my heart be acceptable before you. Meaning, meditation is what? It's a language.
Yes.
Amen.
Because the Bible says, let it be acceptable in your sight. Meaning, meditation is a way of expression in the realms of the spirit.
Amen.
And
amen.
Every expression is a language. Because even in silence, there's something called body language.
That's true.
So meditation is a language in the spirit realm where man or spirit beings communicate among themselves by something called telepathy. Let me teach you this mystery by the message of the Lord Jesus. I pray thee that whenever you encounter the angel of the Lord, sometimes there's something called telepathical speech where the angel is not speaking, but he's speaking. You don't see the angel open up his mouth, but he's speaking to you, and you understand what he's speaking.
That's right.
It's called realms of meditation.
Meditation.
Why do you think that even people, in, excuse me to say, these ungodly religions do something called meditation? Why do you think that among all these religious bodies, there is a knowledge beneath all these bodies called meditation. Why do you think there's something called meditation? Everything you see being done in darkness actually is a perverted knowledge in the realms of light. So if people of the world are doing something called meditation, even yoga people do meditation. So if people of the world are doing something called meditation and children of the kingdom have no idea called meditation, then it is really sad, because meditation is a thing of the spirit.
Jesus.
Meditation opens the windows of your mind to knowledge and deep mysteries.
Yes.
Amen.
Deep mysteries.
It is only in meditation that is where mysteries are birthed out. Meditation is key in the kingdom. The last time I was speaking to my spiritual father, Papa was telling me mysteries about meditation. That before you even minister, there's something called meditation that he does. I was listening to Grandpa Papa Lo, and he was saying, before he even preaches, he just take a scripture, then he becomes silent for some time. And what is more to be? This is called meditation.
Amen.
Meditation is the thing of the spirit. Meditation opens your mind up to deep understanding and deep knowledge.
Amen.
Let me give you this mystery, and I want you to try it. Whenever you're about to do any business or anything, I want you to be in silence mode. Start pondering over it. Start pondering over what you're about to do. I tell you by the message of the Lord Jesus Christ, automatically your mind opens up. Like there is one thing that opens, like it's like a gate that has been opened out. Now you start, you are able to think critically, you are able to think something deep that an abnormal circumstance you will never think of. It's not because it is hidden in you, no, it's because your mind has been opened to the things of the Spirit.
Amen.
See, one thing I have come to understand is that there's nothing hidden in the realms of the Spirit. So if a person is able to enter into the realms of the Spirit, we are able to catch things that are flying in the realms of the Spirit or in the thin air, because the air is the realm of the Spirit.
Mm-hmm.
This is a knowledge. This is a mystery that I cannot share now. But everything about the wind, the air, is a spirit.
Amen.
Amen.
Yes.
Information are just flying in the air. So why do you think that we are able to call and just this phone is able to call someone in America and we're able to speak by the waves? Because waves is a spirit.
Yes.
These are things of the spirit.
Amen.
Amen.
So whenever you enter into the state of meditation, your mind opens up. Now, after your mind opens up, the Spirit of the Lord is able to guide you to right knowledge. Because one thing is this, whenever your mind opens to the things of the Spirit, every knowledge is in the Spirit, both good and bad.
Amen.
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 Whenever the gates of your mind is open to the spirit realm, both good knowledge and bad knowledge flies in the realms of the spirit. The Spirit of God is now able to oscillate your thinking to the right knowledge.
Yes.
Is it a deep teaching?
Yeah, go ahead.
Good.
I wish you understand what I'm trying to say.
Yeah, we do.
notes.
Amen. I want you to try this thing from tonight.
Mm. Yes.
Whenever you're about to close that business deal, whenever you are about to do the particular project, I want you to be in your silence mood. Whenever maybe you're about to minister or do anything, I want you to be in that particular silence mood. That you are thinking of nothing but only the Lord Jesus Christ, only the scriptures you're about to preach, because everything you're about to say can make and or make people. So I cannot come to your presence to beautiful saints like you and just speak any word, because any word that I speak to you, it is a spirit I'm preaching to you, I'm pushing to you. This spirit has the ability to make you and not make you. That is why we will be judged by every word that we speak. Everything I'm saying now is pushing you to another level of your life.
Amen. With bad
information, automatically I'm pushing you to a wrong doctrine.
Yes, push.
Whenever you're about to minister or do anything, whenever you're about to do that business zero or do any particular thing, I want you to be in that state of silence by the power of the Holy Spirit. Be in that state of silence. Start thinking about what you're about to do. If it's ministry or ministration, start thinking about it. Start thinking about that scripture. Mm. One thing, a particular thing will just dump into your mind. You've never thought of that thing before. The reason you're able to capture that thing is because that thing is already existing in the realms of the spirit. But your mind has not opened up to that particular revelation. But when you're in a state of meditation and you've opened your spirit up, now the Spirit of the Lord Jesus Christ, which is in that line with your spirit, is able to oscillate you into that particular line of knowledge.
And now
mysteries are let out.
Real
good. Amen.
Don't teach.
Mm-hmm.
Because this is deep mystery.
Yes, Lord.
Mm-hmm.
Somebody say meditation.
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 When it's used the wrong way, calamity always comes in. When it's used in the wrong way, calamity always comes in.
Ah, my Jesus.
Mm-hmm. We are praying one prayer and I'll be out of your way. The Father, O God, give us the strength to meditate. In the name of Jesus, lift up your voice wherever you are.
Amen.
In the mighty name of Jesus.
Wherever you are, I want you to put your right hand on your head.
Yes.
We are praying this prayer. Listen to me, wherever you are. I want you to pray with all diligence because this is another phase of your life. This is another realm we've entered right now. We are praying and telling God, the Father, let the eyes of our understanding be enlightened. Yes. Father, let the eyes of our understanding be enlightened. Let us, oh God, enter into another realm of our life, another realm of business, another realm of ministry, another realm of life in every facet of our life. Lift up your voice and pray like never before. Malika, so my Katina, I am a man of the world.
My God. Yes.
In the realms of the spirit, as you are praying right now, the Lord just opened my eyes.
Yes.
To someone having infirmity in her blood, having sickness, disease in her blood. The Lord is telling me to pray for that person.
Yes.
If you're having any disease in the blood, the Lord is telling me to pray for you right now. By this word, I pray for you, whoever is on the line, having any form of disease in the blood, I pray for you in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. I stand in the grace of my Father, Apostle Jean Elias, and I pray for you in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Let every disease vanish. The next time you visit the hospital, may they find no trace of the disease in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. I pray for you. Let the disease vanish now. Let the disease vanish now. I pray for a new beginning for you. Every disease in your blood, I cause it to vanish now in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Every disease in your bloodstream, I cause it to vanish now in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Anyone having any form of disease in the ears, anyone having form of any defect in the ears, I pray for you in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Let that disease vanish now. Let that sickness vanish now. Let that pain vanish now. Anyone having pains in the eyes, I pray for you in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Let that pain vanish now in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Let that pain vanish now. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Any disease, Kaliba, I Lejona Michael Mangova Akoski, Mareka Tile Elo Mariaka, Bazonde Iloda Baikato, Lekanona Masuke Prias, Lejon de Vendo Kule Aikapai, Palujaneka Oskapea, Le Aika Fando Sandeas. Every disease, every infirmity that is hidden in the body, any demon that is hidden in the body, in the form of any disease. 1, 2, 3, 4, now manifest, and I cause you to go now in the mighty name of Jesus.
Yes. Amen.
Hallelujah.
Holy Spirit, let every demon in the form of sickness hidden in the blood of anyone on the page. I see 4 people on the page right now. I see disease hidden in the blood. I cause it to vanish now in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ. 1, 2, 3, 4. Now I cause you to vanish every pain. 1, 2, 3, 4. Now, move out of the body in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Every defect in the system, I cause you to vanish now. I see things in weather around people now. I see someone having some deep sensation under your feet, something like a burning sensation under your feet. I see another person having some cold around your body. I see another person having flashes of light on your eyes. A lesion like a valley of myosha, the cause the kai kadule ezandi braika. I cause every demonic activity of the enemy in your life to shut down now in the name of Jesus Christ. Every sickness, every demonic personality hidden as sickness in your body. Alikoba aiketile azombe ilosh kapai. Levino kupe likom takilo dai. I cause you demon being to lose your hold. Iba liko zandiva aikataya. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, I see all of a sudden. I see. I want us to pray one prayer. Because all of a sudden, I see myself at a hospital, and I see myself at an emergency center. I see someone that has been rushed to the hospital now. We are praying and telling God that anyone on the page right now, that the devil has set a date for a demonic accident to happen to the person, let that thing be averted in the mighty name of Jesus Christ, because I was carried by the angel of the Lord into the day 22, which is 22nd of July 2022. I see an emergency, someone being rushed to the hospital, and Jesus. I see drips being put on the person, and I see the person entering into an ICU center. We are praying and telling God, any attack of the enemy that has been pushed to the 22nd of this month, let that thing be affected. You might not know that it might be you. Lift up your voice and pray and counsel it now. In the name of Jesus.
In the name of Jesus.
I do not know who is in Alta International. A male. It's like this person uses hand tools to work. The person uses hand tools. It's like in your field of work, you use hand tools. Like this kind of hand tools, you use it to work. Okay. The person uses hand tools to work. Hand tools to work. Yeah. I see that person. I want us to pray for the person. Any emergency. Because in the realms of the spirit, I'm seeing a male. And what the angel of the Lord is showing me by the message of the Lord Jesus, I see this person using hand tools. I don't know if you know hand tools. The person uses, he has a tools box that you pick your tools from in, and he uses that tools to work, okay, on things, whether machines or something.
But deeper prophet,
this person being rushed to the ICU.
Jesus.
We pray that let that attack of the enemy be averted.
Yeah.
Because I see it as a plan on the calendar of the enemy, which is 22nd. Listen to me, ladies and gentlemen. I want you to pray like it, as if it's you. that every person or any person in altar that uses hand tools to work.
Yes.
Every attack of the enemy against the life of this person, let it be averted. Because in the realms of the spirit, I see a talika, a card, and I see blood drips on the card.
Jesus.
And I see not being a good news. But we are praying and telling God as one family that any attack of the enemy that has been scheduled for this month 22nd, that a bad news should hit the family of altar. We come together as one big family. I pray that you pray diligently as if it's you, because I've not mentioned the name of the person, so it can be anyone. I want you to pray like never before that any attack of the enemy against any member in altar, let that attack be averted. We come together as one family, with one spirit and with one voice. Let that attack in the mighty name of Jesus Christ be averted.
Yes,
in the name of Jesus.
In the mighty name of Jesus.
In the name of Jesus.
Yes.
In the mighty name of Jesus.
Yes. In the name of Jesus.
I pray for anyone on the page that works with their hand, with hand tools. Anyone in the field of plumbering that deals with pipes of houses, I pray for such a person. Let the protection of the Lord be upon his life.
In the mighty name of Jesus Christ.
Every attack of the enemy be averted in the mighty name of Jesus.
Yes, Father.
Every attack of the enemy averted in the name of Jesus. I see the attack coming like a heart attack. I rebuke it in the name of Jesus.
The mighty name of Jesus.
Every heart attack of the enemy against the life of the person, we avert it in the name of the living Jesus Christ.
In the name of Jesus.
We cancel it in Jesus' name.
Jesus' name.
Now, I pray for everyone that is connected to any member of altar that is pregnant. I see someone who is pregnant, connected to altar, whether a family member, but I pray for the child of this person. I see an ultrasound being taken, and I see the person carrying a male child.
Yes.
I see the person carrying a male child. I see the ultrasound. We prophetically have entered into a hospital, and I see this lady lying down, and I see the scan being made, and I see a male child. But this child has not been positioned right. I position that child right in the name of Jesus Christ. And I cancel any form of complication in the name of the living Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Any complication will come during the birth of this child.
Yes, God.
In the mighty name of Jesus Christ.
Yes,
the mighty name of Jesus. Of the enemy will ever be this child. In the name of my Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. Now I pray for everyone on the page, that let the Lord order your steps in this new season you've entered into. Let the Lord order your steps in the second half of this year. Every deal that has not materialized, I cause it to materialize with the grace of my Father, Apostle John Elias. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, I pray that every deal you are praying to land and to close, let it be closed in the name of Jesus Christ. I pray, let the Lord protect you. Let the Lord cause his face to shine upon you in the mighty name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Amen.
Now, I want us to do this direction.
Mm-hmm.
I don't know what you want to get by the end of this year. But we have entered into the second half of the year. And I saw the number 8, which represents a new beginning. Mm-hmm. I want us to, everyone, take a seed of 108. Everyone, take a seed of 108.
Yes.
And I want you to declare that, Father, with this offering, I speak into the year or the second half of the year.
Yes.
Let every business deal, let every deal I want to materialize. Every aspiration that I want it to materialize, let it materialize. Every blessing that I want to see, let me see. As I take this seed of 108, Father, I use it as a token of remembrance, and I use it as a sacrifice of my sword. Let every person that has been captured in the realms of the spirit be released by this offering in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. I want you to pick that seed right now, and I want you to pray on the seed right now, and I want you to sow the seed after you have prayed. Listen to me, ladies and gentlemen. I want to share this mystery with you. Whenever you enter into another dimension of your life, there are always gatekeepers of that dimension.
That's right. That's right.
Amen.
Amen.
That's right.
Whenever you enter any dimension, you should realize there are gatekeepers of every dimension. Your sacrifice will determine whether you will maintain that direction or you'll be a seer of that direction, meaning you just see the direction, you see glimpse of that dimension and come back to your old self.
My God.
When Daniel wanted to take preeminence in the jurisdiction of Persia, he prayed, but that prayer was captured by a principality called the Prince of Persia. For Daniel to have preeminence and dominance over Persia, Archangel Michael needed to be released to destroy that prince of Persia for Daniel to have total governance in the region of Persia.
Amen.
Why? Because the dimension Daniel wanted to enter into, there was a prince in that particular dimension.
Amen.
Who was the gatekeeper of that dimension?
My God.
The prayer and offering of Daniel caused him to have preeminence in that dimension.
That's right. Amen.
Amen.
We are entering into another phase of the year 2022. Another dimension, another level. For you to take preeminence in this dimension, it comes with prayer and blood, which is sacrifice.
Ooh, when Jesus.
When the angel of the Lord met Cornelius, he said, Cornelius, your prayer and almsgiving have served as a memorial before the Lord. And I have come to reveal unto you that go to a man in Joppa called Peter to come and minister the gospel to you. The offering and sacrifices and prayer of a non-believer caused an angel to come to speak to an unbeliever.
Yes.
The Bible makes us understand. And when Balaam told Balak to sacrifice on the seven altars, the Lord spoke to Balaam, who, excuse me to say, a false prophet, a sorcerer.
Mm-hmm.
God was still speaking to him.
Offering
a sacrifice.
Mm-hmm. Mm.
Ladies and gentlemen, the Bible said, and God said in his heart, that I will not destroy man again, though the imaginations of men is wicked from the new. Genesis 8, verse 22, verse 20 to 22. And the Bible said, because of the offerings of a man called Noah.
Mm-hmm.
Sacrifice is a principle in the realms of the spirit that causes the supernatural to have entanglement with the natural.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Right, that's right.
Listen to me, ladies and gentlemen.
Yes.
This is a principle of the kingdom.
Mm-hmm.
This is a principle that have caused many people to search in life. Why do you think that even people of the world do something called charity? That every time they are pumping money into charity, but they are always being called the world top richest. Why don't their money get finished? No, because the more they pump something called charity, the more their money increases, because sowing is a thing of the spirit.
Amen.
Amen.
If a sower reaps bountifully 30s, 60s, and 100 folds.
Yes.
Ladies and gentlemen, I want you to take an offering.
Mm-hmm.
Of 108 and above.
Yes.
And say, Father, with this offering,
mm-hmm.
I go on a covenant with you.
Yes.
I go on a covenant with my family with you. I pray by this offering, let a door open for my son. Mm-hmm. By this offering, let a door open for my daughter. By this offering, let a door open for my sibling, for myself.
Yes.
By this offering, let that business contract close. By this offering, let that particular business deal close. By this offering, let that anointing, that grace come. You see, ladies and gentlemen, I don't want to speak much, not by the abundance of my words, but this is a principle of the kingdom.
Yes.
That if you know how to execute this principle, your prayer life becomes smooth, because always you get what you want. I'm giving you just 1 minute. Take this offering and speak over the offering right now.
Yes.
Wherever you are.
Yes.
Speak over the offering right now. And I want you to sow the offering.
Thank you, Jesus.
I want you to sow the offering right now.
Thank you, Jesus.
Miss Val, if you can put the various platforms, I want you to sow it right now.
Yes.
I'm waiting for you. After you are done sowing, I will come back and pray a special prayer for you. I want you to sow it right now.
Yes.
I want you to sow it right now. Let's take an offering of 108.
Yes.
I'm waiting for you. I want everyone to get involved.
Mm-hmm.
I'm waiting for you. Kalibado Shadibai Kalibado. Ramandevia Kriyoshkaba. I'm waiting for you. Kaliba Aikatina Masuski Paradios. I want everyone to be involved. Everyone. We sow not because of where we are, but because of where we want to get to.
Yes.
I'm waiting for you. Maybe you cannot do 108. Maybe yours is 50. I want you to do 5-8 right now. I want everyone to get involved.
Yes, yes, sir.
No one should be left behind.
Yes, sir.
Because this is a portal you have entered into. Maybe you cannot do the 108. Maybe your strength is 5-8. I want you to do 5-8 right now.
Jesus.
I'm waiting for you to. Maybe your strength is not 108. Your strength is 5-8. I want you to do 5-8. 8 need to be in it. 8 is a number of new beginning.
Yes.
Obedience is better than sacrifice. I want you to just obey the voice of the prophet by grace. 5-8. I'm waiting for you too.
Yes.
I'm waiting for you too. I want everyone to get involved.
Yes.
Maybe your strength is not 5-8. You want to do 3-8. I want you to do it also. I want everyone to get involved. Maybe that is your strength. That is your last sacrifice. That is your last that you have. I want you to sow that too.
Yes. Yes.
Today is a special moment.
Yes, it is.
Don't let it pass you by.
Yes, it is.
Don't say that tomorrow you will do it, because tomorrow is never promised. Maybe the angel of the Lord that has visited us today has your blessing in his hand. What are you willing to offer on the altar for the exchange? Because it's only on altar that is exchange. In the spirit world, nothing is exchanged by itself. It only takes place on altars.
Yes.
On altar. In altar. I want you to do this offering.
Mm.
108, 5-8, 3-8. I want everyone to get involved. Provided you are online, do not miss this. Do not miss this moment. This is your moment. I pray for you wherever you are. Father, look at their hearts.
Yes, Jesus.
And offer your blessings unto them. In Jesus' name, amen.
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 Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
God, which will bless you all. Mama Denise, please, you can take over.
Oh my God. Yes. Yes, son. Definitely. This is an incredible opportunity. Moderator, if you would please put up the online giving again, if you would put it up again. I want to reiterate to them. Go to PayPal. And you can do prayertimewiththeapostle.com. There at PayPal, go to prayertimewiththeapostle.com. Or you can go to prayertimewiththeapostle.com. You can go to the site. You can go to the website, and you can also click the donate button, and it'll take you directly to PayPal, where you can also give your seed as well. The seed of 108. I reiterate, the seed of 108. Prophet Naz has also said, if you do not have the 108, which we probably all do, let's do the 108, do the 50, do the 58, do 58. Make sure you stay in the prophetic order that the prophet has spoken today, 58 or the 108. And he commissioned all of us to do it, all of us. Go to taichurch.com. You can also click the QR code with your phones, and you can go there as well. But you can also go to the site, www.taichurch.com. And those of you that use Cash App, you can do that. Do use the Cash App by going to $Apostle of Cash. Yes, $Apostle of Cash. And you also have mail your offering to P.O. Box 1745, Upper Marlboro, Maryland. Again, P.O. Box 1745, Upper Marlboro, Maryland. These are the ways in which you can give of your offering tonight. Let's all be obedient unto the prophetic word, that awesome prophetic word that has been brought to us today. There is a woman that's on the line, if I may say so. And if you're here, I'll just pray for you. Please release me to pray. There's a woman with a son. Your son is between the ages of 8 and 11, and he's a joy of your heart. And I pray right now for the protection over your son. I pray for you as the mother over that son to be, have the instructions, have the leadership of the Holy Ghost in order to raise up that son in the way he should go. God has his hand on him, and he is going to be a mighty man of God. Yes, yes, a young man between the ages of 8 and 11. And the mother, he is the joy of your heart. He makes you smile. And I want you to know that the blessings of the Lord is upon your son, and that God is going to bless you. And it is a young man in comparison to what the prophet spoke this afternoon, stating that there was a woman that was pregnant and having a son. Blessing unto you as well. And then there's an older woman, and you have been having some bleeding. You've had some bleeding going on, and to the point that it's a pad that you're wearing, and it's uncomfortable. And I pray right now for the blessings of the Lord. I ask you to release the blessings of the Lord God unto her heart, and give her the peace of God. Give her the peace of God in the midst of this turbulence, in the midst of this that's happening with her. I ask you that you would bring about a healing to her body. It almost went to a place of a hemorrhage. And I want you to know that God has heard your cry. God has heard you, and he wants you to know that he's going to do something about it, that he's doing something about it, and that you are not by yourself. You are not by yourself, that God is going to bless you, and he's heard your cry. And I ask the Lord to heal you. I ask the Lord to stop the bleeding. I ask the Lord to bring about a blessing over your life in the glorious name of Jesus Christ. And I thank you so much. That man that Prophet Naz spoke about, that man, he works, yes, he works with tools. He works with tools. We've seen it clearly. He works with heavy tools. Yes. He works with heavy tools, and I see him walking and pushing the tools. Yes. The Spirit of the Lord has spoke a blessing over your life, just as the prophet has spoken today, and it's very clear. And you know who you are. You know what the prophet is saying. I thank God for the opportunity for Prophet Naz to speak to us tonight. How many of you have been extremely blessed? How many of you have been blessed?
Amen.
Amen.
Prophetic mantle is in this call. The prophetic mantle is on this call. The blessings of the Lord, he released it. He released every opportunity of blessing to be on you. He released every opportunity of outpour, every opportunity for the operation of the Lord to be in your lives here on this Zoom call. So for those of you that have a heart to understand, that a heart not of stone, but a heart of flesh, in order to hear what the prophet has spoke today. The prophet is the voice of God. And when he speaks, You have to listen and you have to be in obedience. We serve under Apostle Gene Elias, a tremendous seer before the Lord. The mantle is upon those that are diligent upon seeking after the heart of God under the direction of Apostle Gene Elias. And if you are one of his sons and his daughters, then the prophetic word will come into your life and it will manifest into your life and it will operate in your life. He has imparted it into us, and therefore we will hear to in order to bless the world. We're on YouTube. God bless you, YouTube. We're on Instagram. God bless you, those on Instagram. God bless you, those that are on Twitter. God bless you for those that are on TikTok that are listening to the voice of Apostle Gene Elias. Apostle Gene Elias is the son of the seer, Prophet Lovey Elias, and the blessings of the Lord are over his life, and he has trickled them down and imparted them into this man of God. And if Apostle Gene Elias is your leader, is the one you submit to, then we expect you as leaders here to be in one accord and to be right there. You can't overjump him and go to his father, because his father will reject you. So I want you to understand that, and I want you to really, really apprehend that and know that the blessings of the Lord are in order. God operates decently and in order by the body of Christ. If you would, moderator, would you please put up for us the ways in which they can connect with us, please? The ways in which they can connect. You can connect with us here at the Altar Church, 77@gmail.com. Altar Church 77@gmail.com. Any of the things that I've just spoken unto you, if you want to let the ministers here, let them know that it was you that Prophet Naz was talking about. The prophetic word was given to you. If it was you that the prophetic word was, that you remember, that you see that it is you, send us an email, alterchurch77@gmail.com. Again, alterchurch77@gmail.com. And for those of you that are on, that want to go on TikTok, you can do that by @theapostleofcash, or those of you that want to connect with him on Twitter, you can do that @apostleofcash. And also those of you on Instagram, yes, on Instagram, if you want to see all the marvelous things that he has on Instagram, you can do that by going to @apostleofcash. Yes, @apostleofcash. And those of you that are looking at us and on the Zoom, and you want to follow us also on YouTube, and you want to see some of the rhema and which Apostle Gene Elias has out there, and you, 24 hours a day, you can go on YouTube and you can hear the voice and the instruction from the man of God, Apostle Gene Elias, anytime in the comfort of your home. You can do it by going to on YouTube, Apostle of Cash. That's right. And moderator, if you would show us the various other ways in which we come to you and to bring the voice of the Apostle Gene Elias unto you. You can do it by also every day, Monday through Friday, you can join Pastor Issa and Pastor Curtis at 7:15 a.m. on the healing room. And they reiterate the words of our Apostle Gene Elias, and they bring forth the word of God to you every day, Monday through Friday, 7:15 a.m. And it's a wonderful place to be. And our midweek service starts on Wednesday. That's right, Wednesday. Some people call it hump day, but we call it our midweek service day, where testimonies abound and where the blessings of the Lord start our weeks off. And we are blessed. We are blessed, 7 p.m. Eastern Standard Time. And on Thursday nights, the Dominion Hour, that's the prophetic hour in which we come together, unified as a body of believers, to pray the manifestation of the blessings of the Lord under the leadership of Apostle Gene Elias. My God. And Mame is right there with us. Oh God, if you were blessed earlier, you'd be blessed on Thursdays. And also on Fridays, let's just like tonight, this is our Friday miracle service. That's right. And miracles abound. The mantle of the prophetic will come to pass. The blessings of the Lord will abound upon you, my God. And on Sunday, yes, on Sunday, we'll hear from our Apostle Gene Elias. Yes, we will. In the direction and in the leadership of this awesome man of God, Sunday, be a part of it. 11 o'clock a.m. Eastern Standard Time. May the blessings of the Lord be yours. So for no further ado, God bless you all. God bless you. God bless you. Remember, sow that $108 seed. Yes, sow. Be obedient to the prophetic word brought forth tonight. And he also gave you the other word. He says, if 108 is not within your ring right now, your reach, do the 58. Push. Let's push for this blessing. How many of you want to push for this blessing? And how many of you have? How many of you have? I salute you, those of you that have.
Amen.
Those of you that are on YouTube, let's do it. Let's come together, unify in this blessing. God bless you. God bless you. God bless you. Moderator, take it away.
Bless you, Mother Denise. Amen.
I will trust in the Lord all my days, all my days. I will trust in the Lord all my days, all my days. I will be satisfied with you. I will be satisfied with you. Said, I will be satisfied with you. Said, I will be satisfied with you. Yeah. Say, I will trust in the Lord,
in the Lord,
all my days,
all my days.
Yeah.
All my days.
Said, I will trust in the Lord,
in the Lord,
all my days,
all my days,
all my days. Come on, lift it up, I will be satisfied. Hey, Lord, I am
satisfied.
Whatever may come, oh God, I'm
satisfied.
Oh Lord, oh Lord, I am
satisfied.
Yeah. And where you lead, I'll go. And I will trust your complete control. I will be satisfied with you. Oh, where you lead, I'll go. I will trust your word, God.
Trust your word.
You have complete control. Come on, say,
I will be satisfied with you.
Come on, you better come on. Where you lead, I'll
go.
Nobody. teaching me a little bit. They're teaching me. The old and the new, I will trust you. This is all it is. It's a big argument going on. Is you have complete control, but it's the same thing. It said I will be where you lead, where you lead. It said I will trust you. You have complete control. Said I will be there.